to read their minds, and they want to see their foot or the obstacles while they are moving, because otherwise they are going to die. So nature is great, and like they modify our system, and bats can send ultrasound signals to detect the object or the obstacle. So this is called ecology. So bats have the bats use these echoes to locate either for small or closer objects or for further objects. So these are different kind of signals that they are seeing. And
when sorry, can we have the door shut so we can hear what you're saying?
I'm sorry about that. My voice is a bit low. I'm sorry. Yeah. So let's go back to this for a bit before. So bats can use two different sound signals, two different frequency patterns, let's say. Because here we use one frequency and here we can use multiple frequencies. But when we say frequency, what are we actually talking about? So frequency is we use the word frequent, like how often one event can occur. In the ultrasound sense or in any wave sense, so how many peaks? 1, 2, 3. In the 1 second period determines the frequency of the sound or any other thing. Like we have a 3 hertz signal here. So hertz is the unit of the frequency. Like when I say this is 5 meter away, so the meter is the unit, but here hertz is the frequency. And echolocation, as I said before, we use single frequency for the closer or smaller objects and multiple frequency, which is very complex actually to replicate in the engineering application. So they use the same. And it also depends where the frequency that you want to choose, like small, like the level of this frequency, small or higher. So it depends if you are on the air or water. So when we say the frequency, when we look at the frequencies, different for the sound. So we have a longer wavelengths for smaller frequencies and higher wavelengths for the higher frequencies. And our bats are actually standing here, just above our hearing edge, which is called acoustic. So bats send the signal, so we use much higher frequency, much smaller wavelengths to diagnose our specimens, or let's say our aircraft here. And how do we do that? How ultrasound work? Actually, it's the same principle. We have an object, or the food in the bat case, and we send our echo, and we receive it back, and process it in our computers, but bats use this on body. So it's also like more visual here, but we have one specimen, we send the signal and we receive it back one more peak. If there is some obstacle on the way, so it came a bit lower than the other one. So we also use this method as medical when you go to an echogram to define the gender